Oh.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm not sure this is on. I just want to, on behalf of Sandy's family, thank everyone for being here today, and we are going to start the service. Dre is going to come forward and share memories with you, and he's going to do a fantastic job.
Like Lorna said, I'm Dre. I'm the third, three out of four. On behalf of my mom and my brother and my sisters, I'd like to thank everybody for coming. I got this. David Patrick Prentice entered this world on January 1st, 1946. which he was the first one that year. He was one of four boys to Bill and Violet. His large family included Marilyn, Billy, Eddie, Alan, Woody, Walter, Valerie, Jimmy, and Danny. He was very proud to be apprenticed, and he loved his family. He grew up in the West End of Windsor and met his love of his life, Sandy. They married and had four. Dane, Dree, me, and Chantal. Mom and Dad loved to spend time traveling, often sneaking off for a last-minute vacation to Niagara Falls, Florida, Vegas, and the last trip together was to Vermont. They loved to go to the river and fish together. Dad always said that he taught Mom so well that she even outfished him. He had nicknames for Mom. Mama, Graham, and I think this one was Caitlin's favorite, the old boot. They celebrated 55 years of marriage last May.
Yep.
Dad always had a story to tell. Quite often, we never knew if it was true or not. As everybody knows my dad. When we were young, he told us he graduated from the University of Windsor, only to find out years later, that he failed grade 6 three times. Again, the stories, we're not sure if they're true. He told us when he applied at Chrysler's, he was so thin that he had to put dimes in his pockets just to pass the weight requirements. Again, one of his stories. When I applied there, he asked me if I told him I got hired. He said, "So you must have passed the spoon test." Some of your older relatives would, maybe it was a joke back then, you put a spoon to your nose, and if it was a little bit of a, if you were breathing, you could get in there. One fall night, Dad and Mom were drinking over at Uncle Eddie's. I believe this is how the story goes. The neighbor from across the street, Johnny Fountain, somehow talked him into moving out west. I knew it was always a dream of his because our kitchen had a mural of a western landscape. So Dad and Dane packed up to begin that adventure. Mom, Dree, Chantal, and I headed out by train since Mom didn't like to fly. Who knew how many adventures Dad would take us on out there? Picnics in the mountains, fishing in the ocean, Alaskan camping trip, and trips to the Indian village. He took Dane on a hike one time, all because he was betting one of his buddies from work a paycheck. It was to walk to Terrace, which was about 64 kilometers hike. He bet his week. The bet was a week's paycheck, so he knew damn well he was going to win. Same with Dane. He was strong-willed. They were both going to win. After six short years out west, Dad decided to head back to Ontario to reconnect with his family. Mom, Chantal, and I followed him back by Greyhound bus. First stop was in Edmonton, Alberta to visit Dane and Dree. When we met up with Dad back in Ontario, he had everything set up. A house, a car, and a job. It was a great reunion with our family, like we had never even left. Years flew by, and it wasn't long before we were all married with our families of our own. Dad never hesitated to help us out in any way he could, whether it was ripping up Uncle Gordy's carpet. He was away. Or digging a trench. Anything hard work he loved to do. It passed the time for him. He worked alongside Dane and I, building a house for Dree and Jim, two houses for Mom and Dad. We all knew that Dad loved us until we became a grandpa. His love and pride burst with the arrival of each grandchild. Caitlin, Calvin, Madison, Zachary, Sabrina, Damien, Haley, Ethan, Maya, and Kylie.
And Megan.
I forget Maggie. And my favorite, Maggie. He adored his great-granddaughter, Danica. My grandson, Axton, is his great-grandson. Because of Dad's illness and pandemic, he didn't get to enjoy him, but we all know that he loved him. Dad was loved by all his nieces and nephews and by all of our friends. Dad loved him too, and the boys would all have nicknames for him. They call him Bubba, Mr. P, Mr. Clean. Dad sure loved a cold beer. He also loved to share his recipe with friends and whoever else would drink it. It was this cherry whiskey concoction that Mom and one of his old buddies gave him. Dad made friends wherever he went. Many times I've introduced myself to someone new, and they were like, Dave's boy? Oh yeah, great guy. I had a beer with him one time at the McGregor or the Legion or the Grand. He loved to sing and dance, often screwing around on job sites, doing the cha-cha-cha. This may have been to get under Brother Dane's skin. Sometimes it worked. He had lots of singing, silly songs. This is one of my sister Chantal's favorites. He always had goofy sayings and songs. Gene made a machine. Joe made it go. Art let a fart and blew the engine all apart. Dad had a good life. He knew how to have a good time, and he maxed out his fun card. When my dad passed away, me and my little sister were in the room, and instantly a song came to my head. We were always brought up on country music, and this is the country songs. Just came to my head. Lauren is going to play it for you guys. It means a lot to me.
We loaded up our station wagon with cold and sleeping bags. Fishing boats, the Coolora coast, 3 days before we had to be back. When you're in seventh heaven, when you're going camping in the wild outdoors. As we turned off on that old dirt road, you looked at me and swore, Dad, this could be the best day of my life. I've been dreaming. fun we'll have. Just me and you, doing what I've always wanted to. I'm the luckiest boy alive. This is the best day of my life. It's the day your birthday rolled around. Classic car is the worst thing. When I'm old in the drive of that old vet, I thought that war would go insane. When you're in your teens, your dreams revolve around four spinning wheels. We worked nights on end till it was new again. And as he sat behind the wheel, he said, "Dad, this could be the best day of my life. I've been dreaming day and night about the fun we've had. Just me and you, doing what I've always wanted to. I'm the luckiest boy alive. This is the best day of my life." Standing in a little room, back of the church with our tuxes on. Looking at him, I say, "I can't believe, son, that you're grown." He said, "Dad, this could be the best day of my life. I've been dreaming day and night of being like you." That's me and her, watching you and mom I've heard. I'm the luckiest man alive. This is the best day of my life. I'm the luckiest man alive. This is the best day of my life.
That was King George. Yeah, what all is that? Now my niece, Sabrina, is going to come up and say a poem that she wrote for Pop. Thank you.
Good
Thank you, Uncle Dre, for breaking me. I was trying not to cry. Oh, okay. Good afternoon. For those who do not know me, I'm Dave Prentice's daughter, Sabrina Dampos. I'll be reading a poem today for my pop because we shared the love of poetry together. A golden heart start beating, hard-working hands at rest. I broke our hearts to see you go. God only takes the best. They say the memories are golden. Well, maybe that is true. We never wanted memories. We only wanted you. Your life was love and labor. Your love for your family true. You did the best for us. We will always remember you. We sat beside your bedside, our hearts crushed and sore. We did our duty till the end, till we could do no more. In tears we watched you sinking, we watched you fade away. And though our hearts were breaking, we knew you could not stay. Our lips cannot speak how we loved you. Our hearts cannot tell what to say. But God only knows that we missed you in our homes that are lonely today. Thank you so much.
Again, on behalf of Sandy and her children and grandchildren, thank you to everyone for being here with the family today. They would wish nothing more than to be with you and share stories over a meal and I'm sure have a toast to Dave, but unfortunately due to COVID restrictions, that can't happen today. So just, you know, this does conclude our service, and we thank you for being here. And, you know, you can exit once you're ready. Maybe we'll just give the family some private time and then I'm alone. Thank you so much. Would anyone actually, before we go, would anyone like to share a memory? I thought I just heard maybe someone wants to speak. Would anyone like to share an additional story or memory? Or because I never offered that at the beginning, it may not be something that you're ready for. Would there be anyone? I thought I'd, when you were standing in the back, sorry, I thought you'd wanted to say something. No? Okay, sorry to put you on the spot. Thanks so much.